Banno. Banno Irish, Banu is a village and civil parish lying east of Banno Bay on the southwest coast of County Wexford, Ireland. In modern times, the main settlement is the village of Carrig on Banno or Carrig. In Norman times, there was a borough called Banno on Banno Island at the mouth of the bay. This town has since disappeared, probably due to the silting up of the natural harbor channels in the 14th century, and the former island is now attached to the rest of the parish. History. It is believed that the Vikings had a strong early presence in the area due to the survival of numerous Norse place names in the locality. The Norman conquest of Ireland began in Banno Bay in 1169, when three ships commanded by Robert Fitzstephen arrived at the behest of Diarmait MacMurrough. Another group of Normans under Raymond Le Gros landed the following year on the far side of Banno Bay, on the Hook Peninsula, at Badgenbun, which was then called Irish Dundalk Vale. There was a small promontory fort there, easy for the Normans to defend and thereby ensure a safe landing. At Banno Island, the ruins can still be seen of the 13th century Norman Romanus parish church of St. Mary, originally impropriated to the monks of Canterbury. It consists of a nave and chancel. Another famous Norman soldier and officer who landed in the first invasion was Maelor FitzHenry, whose son adopted his father's name, and thus began the Maelor family of County Wexford, who later were prominent in the Wexford Rebellion of 1798. Banno Borough was a borough constituency returning two members to the Parliament of Ireland until the Act of Union, 1800, disenfranchised it. It was a pocket borough with the same proprietor and electors as Clonmines Borough, another rotten borough for the deserted town of Clonmines at the northern limit of Banno Bay. The most prominent local landlords in Banno from the late 17th century were the Boyce family, who lived at Banno House. The last member of the Boyce family left the area in 1948. During the Irish Rebellion of 1798, the fleeing Loyalist garrison of the town of Wexford crossed the nearby Scar at Barrystown on their way to Duncannon Fort. In the late 19th century, the area was heavily involved in the land wars. Geography, geography, geography. Banno is a Roman Catholic parish in the Diocese of Ferns. The parish church in Carrig on Banno was first built in 1856 and has been altered several times since. It has an adjoining cemetery. Carrig also has a national school, Garda station, handball alley post office, a cafe, four estates, a doctor's office, a farm, a corner shop, two bars and public houses. A kilometer away is an Anglican church at Ballaughton, and at nearby Grantstown is an Augustinian priory. There are beaches on Banno Island at Cockle Strand, Blackhall, and Cullenstown. Transport. Wexford local links serve Carrig on Banno on certain days of the week. Bus Irene Route 381 serves Carrig on Banno and Blackhall on Tuesdays, providing a link to and from Wexford. Several buses a day serve Wellington Bridge around 5 kilometers distant. Until September 2010, Wellington Bridge was also served by rail. Sport. The local Gaelic Athletic Association club is Banno Ballymity GAA Club, which has pitches located at Grantstown. The club has two pitches, a stand and an indoor complex with an upstairs viewing area. The adult men's GAA teams currently play junior hurling and intermediate football. Cambogie and ladies' football clubs also reside and use the facilities there. Banno Ballymity Cambogie Club was founded in 1950 and was originally called St. Mary's. It ceased in the mid-1960s and reformed in 1992 as Banno Ballymity. Nearby is Corrich Ramblers Soccer Club. Handball is also played at Ballymity Handball Club. Music. Formed locally, the Daneskassel music group Banno Cumhaltas Sealtwari Irene had over 150 pupils as of 2010. It is a County Wexford branch of Cumhaltas Sealtwari Irene Cumhaltas. Other members of Cumhaltas in the parish include the Gleason family, the Murphy Bros, Sean Stafford, Nick Bennett, and many more traditional musicians and singers. Colfer's Pub is a venue for traditional sessions, and the Phil Murphy Weekend is held every year in Carrick-on-Bannon. People: Anna Maria Hall, Mrs. S. C. Hall, author. Ben Brosnan, Gaelic footballer. == References